9, 11, 13 chords, guitar chords like add 9, extensions. What are all these things? Let's get this sorted out. I'm Jared from SoundGuitarLessons.com. Welcome to episode 16 of my series on chords, harmony, and their music theory on the guitar. Each of these lessons stand on their own, but I will refer to past videos so you can go back and fill in some gaps if you feel like it. What do 9, 11, and 13 chords mean? Well, there are 7 notes in a scale. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti. I recently talked about tertiary chords or tertian chords. That's just chords built with stacked thirds. It's really what you think of as a major chord, a minor chord, a seventh chord. These are all tertiary chords because they are chord tones built in stacks of thirds. So if we take every other note from a scale, 1, 2, 3, 1, 3, skip 4, take 5, 1, 3, 5, skip 6, take 7, 1, 3, 5, 7. That's a major 7 chord. If you keep moving up the scale, the note above 7 is 1 again. 1, 1, 3, 5, 7, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, just keeps repeating like that. But if you played a scale in multiple octaves like that, and you kept the numbers going up instead of going back to 1, well, then what was 1 would be 8, and continuing up that way, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. That means that what was 2 is now 9. What was 3 was labeled as 10. What was 4 was labeled as 11. What was 5 was 12. And what was 6 is 13. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. So if we kept building a tertiary chord with stacked thirds, 1, 3, 5, 7, we added another chord tone, it would be the 9. Yes, it's the same as 2, but as this chord tone idea, because of the tertiary stack concept, it's this third above 7, so we call it 9. 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. Now, we can't actually play all of those in that exact order on the guitar, so we have to rearrange things a bit, but I can rearrange things to play the G major 9 chord that I just outlined with single notes. The root could be here, the major 7 could be here, the major 3rd, the 5, and the 9 on top. Also, when adding these extensions, if you want to add the 9 as a chord tone or keep going up, it's considered totally okay to get rid of the 5, to not play the 5, to give yourself room to add these other chord tones. The 5 is still part of the chord, we're just not playing it, and it's kind of an implied note. Especially on the guitar, because we run out of space so quickly, this is very useful. So a lot of guitar chord shapes that are extended chords don't have the 5 in it. So with this tertiary model of stacked thirds and these notes that are above 7, 9, 11, and 13, we have this sneaky way of using the entire scale as chord tones. 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 13. That's the entire scale, just spread out in stacked thirds. Now, to play all of those on the guitar, obviously we can't because we only have 6 strings, but if we remove the 5, which we said is okay, and we just treat it as implied, we could play a voicing that's pretty simple on the guitar, but includes all those extensions. Open E, major 3rd, major 6, the 9, the sharp 11, and the major 7. Open E and barring on the 11th fret is an E major 13 sharp 11 chord. So we call these extensions 9, 11, and 13 to distinguish them from regular scale notes, and also to distinguish them from the way that 2, 4, and 6 are used as chord tones. A few videos ago, I talked about sus chords, suspended chords. In that lesson, we learned that you can replace the third of a chord with the 2 or the 4 next to it. In that case, when replacing the third with the 2 or 4, we do call them 2 or 4. We don't call them by their extension name because they are functioning as 2 and 4. They are functioning as notes that are right next to 3. And if you check out that video, you'll see that it's because they are going to move to 3. In a sixth chord, which is also called an add sixth chord, it's a triad with a 6 on it. That 6 is actually replacing the function of the 7. So if you add a 6 to a chord that has a 7 already, that's when you call 6 13. So you see there's this way of thinking of the scale and this tertiary stack of every other note as its own structure. And if the note added to the chord is functioning within the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 area, you can call it the number within that realm. If all of those roles are taken up, 1, 3, 5, and 7, and you add any of those other notes, that's when you call them 9, 11, or 13. I know this is a lot and there's all these rules for labeling, but I just have to lay out the facts here in this way. The fun part and the part that really makes it stick is when you start practicing this stuff and using it and exploring it, playing around with it on your own on the guitar. Just a couple more things to address though. Just another little rule here. You can bypass this like perfect stacked structure of this tertiary thing where it's 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11. And add these upper notes, 9, 11, and 13, to a chord that's just a triad. So you have 1, 3, and 5, and then you add a 9 onto it. And that's exactly what it's called. This is an add chord, and you have these added notes. So a triad with a 9 is called an add 9. It's not called a major 9. That actually means the 7 is in there. It's called an add 9. So if you put a 9 on a major 7 chord, 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, that's a major 9 chord. Here's the most common way to play C major 9. The 5 is not included. Just to give us space, we have 1, 3, 7, and 9. But if we just add the 9 to a triad, 1, 3, 5, 9, that's C add 9. In some ways, that difference is subtle because they can kind of function as the same chord. But in some ways, it's also a huge difference if you really listen for the right thing. Here's that C major 9, 1, 3, 7, 9. There's kind of a thickness to it. And then here's C add 9. Whoa. Very open. C major 9. C add 9. Ooh, that's like sparkly when you switch to the add 9. And here are just a few more examples of some chords that have extensions. An A minor 7 chord that you add a 4 to, or an 11, is called an A minor 11 chord. So when you have these extensions in there, like the C major 9 was a C major 7 with a 9. A minor 11 is an A minor 7 with an 11. What's kind of confusing here is that saying 11 actually implies that the 9 could be in there too. And it's kind of like, if you want it, cool. If you don't, fine. It's kind of like the 5. Like, we can take the 5 away to give ourselves room, and we can include the 9 or not include the 9 when we have these higher extensions. So a 13 chord could have the 11 and the 9 in it, and you still call it 13. But to keep things simple, I want you to basically think of these chords as 1, 3, 5, 7, whatever extension, right? So again, A minor 11 is 1, 3, 5, 7 of A minor 11, 1, flat 3, 5, flat 7, and then also with a 4 in it. I like to play the individual notes, but then if we rearrange to play the chord shape, one of my favorite chord voicings, love this, root, flat 7, flat 3, 11, 5. We get the 5 in that one because we have some open strings to use. So a B7 chord, I'll play this shell voicing of a B7. My last video was about shell voicings, check that out. If I add the 13, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, this is B13. So it's a B7 chord with a 13. This is how I want you to think of extended chords by default. You know that more stuff could be added in. If we're on the keyboard or orchestrating things, we could have many more options. But on the guitar, definitely think of the basic chord with that extension on top. B7 with a 13. If you added the 9 in there too, you can still just call it B13. If you start with a 6th chord and you add a 9 to that, then it's called a 6-9 chord. Just a major 6 chord with a 9 added. Here's a common shape for that. Root, 3rd, 6, 9, 5. This is kind of an ending chord a lot of times. That kind of thing. The chord chart that I made that I talk about all the time on this channel shows every chord through 5 different keys, and then every version of each chord in each key, every version of them that is, if you add the 7, if you turn it into sus, if you add each type of extension, and so on. If you don't have that chart already, you can grab a free copy in the description. Of course, let me know in the comments if you have any questions. I know this theory material can be heavy and abstract, but we have to initially kind of just present it and go over it in this way. However, I cannot emphasize enough that in the end, to really understand this stuff, you just have to play around with it on the guitar. You have to use it in your own playing for it to actually click. Now, that's just general theory behind extensions, and I gave you some nice open string chord shapes, some common chord shapes, and these chord types can be used in any genre. But in the next lesson, I'm going to talk about using the extended chords, 9, 11, 13 chords, guitar chord shapes to play them and the theory behind them, specifically for applying it to jazz guitar. In my last video, I taught a method for how to play any jazz chord using just 8 simple movable chord shapes using something called shell voicings. If you're interested in jazz guitar at all and you're not totally comfortable with how to play any chord that might come up in jazz, then definitely check that video out. Next lesson, we're gonna take the shell voicings from the last video, and we're gonna take the theory of extensions from this video, and we're going to combine them together and create extended jazz chords. We're gonna go further with the extensions too and talk about alterations and all the variables that we might need to use them on actual jazz tunes, and we'll put it to the test by playing through some songs as well. In the past, I would have just added that information into this lesson, but I'm trying out a slightly shorter lesson format than I was doing before. Let me know what you think. Is it nice when I break up the information into multiple videos like this, or would it have been better if I just combined this jazz chord extension information into this video all about extensions? If you have any thoughts about that, let me know in the comments. I'm still just refining and trying to figure out how I can do the best job I possibly can with teaching these lessons every week and helping you out by bringing you some music education that hopefully you're finding useful and valuable. See you in another lesson soon. Thanks for watching. Take care.